So, first off, welcome to the very first Anthro New England. So first off, we are going to introduce ourselves. The three people you see here on the stage are the directors and founders of this convention. We don't have a specific con chair in the sense, we are a board of directors. The three of us use our strengths to make this con run fantastically to the best of our capabilities. So, if you don't know me, my name's Molly, also known as Nexus, also known as Gale, also known as Basalt.
Hi guys.
Also known as Dushep. What up, bro?
Bro.
So,
also known as Slider.
Also known as Slider and Rally, with two mascots that I played outside of the furry thing. Yay. So, that actually brings me into how I got into this whole thing. I got into this whole thing because I was the mascot at the University of Vermont. And I got into it because I was Googling mascot videos, and I happened to find a video of these four people dancing up on a black stage like this, and I was like, wow, those are really good mascot costumes. Well, it turns out that that's Duke the Dancing Dog, Squeak the Rat, Dex Raccoon, and JD Puppy. And I was like, whoa, what is this thing? And they were like, oh, you can have one of these costumes on your own, it's not a mascot suit. And I was like, whoa, that's the best thing ever. I'm gonna get one. And then I got four. And now I have two more coming. So it's like an addiction. Yeah. That's all my money. So, I am in this because I love performing, I love being silly, I love getting on stage and making a total, complete fool of myself. See how I said fool? Yeah, that's because this is a PG event, which is gonna be really hard for me, but I'm gonna try. So, keeping that in mind. So yeah, my role here is I am the director of operations. I'm trying to make everything work, all the gears moving in sync. I'm making it operate. I'm also hosting like half of the events. So you're gonna hear me up on the stage a lot. So if you're like sitting in your seat right now and you're like, oh, I hate this girl, that sucks. Because I'm everywhere. Oh, it's the worst. I think I'm involved in like every main ballroom event. Oh, unfortunate. So, next up, we have my boy Jordan, who knows everything about technology because I don't know anything at all. And he's the man. And you know that gorgeous website that we have? That's all him. So, big round of applause for Jordan.
Hey there. As Molly said, I am Jordan, director of technology. I make everything on the background run smooth, beautiful. I tell her how it works, because I know technology's hard, I'm sorry.
It's like magic.
I just make it magic, so it's easy for everybody. So, furry name is Coda. I got into this because I've been a dog person, like, probably since I was born. And one Halloween, I was looking up werewolf costumes. And I was like, these aren't realistic enough. So, after trolling the internet for a little bit, I found Vicks Candy, lover suits. And I was like, I need one of these so I can enter my true form. Yeah, it all comes out. And then just the downward spiral began after that. But I got into this because I've been friends with these two for forever. I've known them both for a long time, and
forever.
And just one night while we were talking, we realized that we each have a unique talent: operations, PR, technology. I was like, yeah, I could do all the back-end systems, and you guys pull it all together. So that's how I got into Anthro New England. Super excited to be here. I'm so glad that all of you came. Next, I'd like to introduce James Foley, our Director of PR.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Hi.
You're woo. Okay, that's descriptive. Thank you. Well, now that you know my full first and last name. Oh, that was gone. Now that you know my full first and last name, Jordan, you idiot. I'm Logan. I'm the Director of Public Relations. If you've ever tweeted at Anthro New England, you've tweeted at me. That's all I do. I live on Twitter. That's my job. It's making me insane that my phone's in my pocket and I can't look at it right now, because I'm sure when I open it up there's going to be like a million people yelling at me. So I got into the fandom. I was actually doing a project in middle school on Anubis, and we all know how that went. Here I am. in the real world, I do marketing, so it made sense for me to come here, and I just talk to you. So email me or tweet at me, and I'll maybe respond to you, maybe. Probably not. I do. I love you all. I love you all so much. You guys rock. Thank you for coming. You're the best.
You know what the most important thing about a furry con is? Okay, yeah, there are some great examples, but some of them better than others. But we're all here because we have a whole lot of passion for animals. I know that sometimes we prefer the anthropomorphic animals like Mickey and Bugs Bunny, but really when it boils down to it, we love animals a lot. And the top priority of any furry convention, the reason we're a nonprofit is because we have amazing charities. And the charity we have at this convention is so fun. They're called Mass Vesta Dog, and they're based here in Massachusetts, and they're making sure that all the happy little doggies and the police have vests. And I have an amazing, amazing woman to introduce you. Everybody say hello to Kathy.
Good morning, everybody. Oh my gosh, this is an exciting crowd. We are so excited to be here. And she talks about how passionate animals. Mass Vesta Dog got its start because my daughter, who was then 11, brought me her American Girl magazine article and had a girl sitting on top of a doghouse, pink doghouse, with a police dog and a vest in front of it. And she brought me the article and she said, "Mom, I want a Vesta Dog." And I looked at her and I said, "Being a mom, you can't even keep your room clean." But we ventured on, and that was over 400 vests ago. We've expanded our mission, so you have to stop by our booth and find out all the other stuff that we help provide for canines and police dogs. And what's really, really, really exciting is at noontime tomorrow, right here, you have a chance to meet a police dog from the Cambridge Police Department. Is that like the coolest thing ever? All right. I'm going to tell you a little thing about this dog. He's an EOD dog. Does anybody know what EOD stands for?
Explosive Ordnance Disposal.
Love it. Explosives, ordnance, detector. He's a bomb dog. So we're going to have a chance to see this bomb dog in action. They will have a little sample of whatever it is, but they have to know 23 cents. Yeah, not a bomb. It's just... they have to know 23 cents. Can you imagine that? Dog needs to know 23 cents. I would... be challenge almost anybody here if you walked into a kitchen to identify 23 cents of something that's cooking. And that's their ability. So we love our dogs, and we are so grateful to all of you guys and gals and furries for supporting our charity this weekend. You gotta stop by our booth because we have a free drawing every single day. It's different. We also have our mascot who will be might be getting out today, but will be Saturday and Sunday. Doesn't have a name. So, we need your help. You can go on our Facebook posts and post on there what the name ought to be, or you can put a name in at our booth. We have a container with lots of paper. You can put as many names as you like in.
And the most important thing is we are going to come up with the three top names you can enter through noontime on Sunday. And at closing ceremonies, we're going to announce the three names that we think are the best names ever. And you guys are going to cheer on, and by your biggest cheer, you will decide. A&E 2015, the very first, is going to name our mascot. So get creative, guys. I know you got it. And again, I want to say thank you so much. Come on, stop over at our booth. Come and say hi to us. Get your picture taken with our mascot. We want to get our picture taken with you guys. It's going to be an awesome weekend, and thank you so much. I'm so grateful. So, if you want to find their table, it's over in the dealer's end, which is right next to here. You'll see it, it's very prominent, it's the first thing you'll see when you walk in. Now, I have two very honorable guests to introduce to you. Two absolutely amazing artists. And they're going to come up on stage. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! Everyone, this. Both of these people are very good friends of mine. This is my good friend, Feibel. Awesome art, amazing art. I can't even. Oh, fun fact, she's not even graduated college yet, and that's how good she is. She's graduating this year. Let's give it up for awesomeness. Next to me, I lovingly refer to this person as Dad. Really the epitome of amazing dadness. A god among mortals. A Canadian among Americans. You were going for Usain Bolt and you missed it. That she's Canadian, she doesn't sports. Val Hunt, everyone! Alright. So you might be thinking, oh my god, why isn't Molly giving them the mic? Because I'm going to embarrass them for an entire hour on stage here at 1 o'clock. It's just the two of them and me on stage for an hour. And it's called Meet of Honor, and oh my god, the questions I'm going to ask them. You're going to be dying. So, all of y'all, come back 1 p.m. and go see her in the dealer's den, and go see her roaming around the con having a really awesome time and maybe suiting? Hopefully suiting, because awesome. Alright, go away! We're a giant fan of all the people that work in this hotel. Yep. They're just awesome. This staff has never, ever experienced a con like this. Ever. They're used to business conventions, right guys?
Pharmaceutical
conventions and business conventions and giant gatherings of college swimmers, which is all the girls you're seeing around here. You know what? But shout out to them because they're awesome and they're participating in a giant college tournament, and let's hope that they win because they're awesome. And they love you guys. Like, they're just taking a million pictures and sending it to all their friends being like, oh my god, what even? So it's great. So yeah, huge shout out to this hotel. They've been amazing to work with. We have so much room here to grow. You guys haven't even seen half of the insane rooms that they have. And let me just tell you that 1 year, this ballroom is not going to be split up anymore. Yeah. It's going to be one giant main ballroom. Woo! So yeah, it's going to get real big in here, which is terrifying. Okay.
And what if the dealer's den was a dealer's nest and you weren't in a dark dungeon anymore and you could actually see outside from the 15th floor?
Yeah.
How cool would that be? Dealers, would you like that? All right.
Don't be so happy with that.
No, I like how
to
lose the question.
PG.
Oh.
So, we have one last thing. Jordan is going to end this all with a couple of thank yous.
First off, thank every single one of you for showing up. Woo! The attendees are what makes Anthony New England. Thank you so much. Working up, I'd like to thank everyone who has volunteered. Your help is greatly appreciated. We love you. Oh my gosh. Next, I'd like to step through my staff. Let's start out with Shane and Teddy, who are working in the dealer's den. They are making sure everyone's happy, everyone's got what they need. We love you guys. I hope they can hear us. We have Lou, who's working the game room. He is staying up pretty much every single night, making sure the games are protected, making sure everyone's got power 24 hours. Yeah, that room's open all the time. So he's making sure the game room's got everything it needs. Shout out to him for getting that totally squared away. Love you! He's probably asleep right now. All right, next we have our AV guy, Drek. Look at this. How beautiful is this? Awesome job. Thank you so much. Next we have Hunter, our volunteer coordinator. You've probably talked to him if you volunteered. He's working diligently to make sure we have all positions filled, and he's doing an amazing, amazing job. Next we have Pup, our security coordinator, who's probably walking around, making sure everybody's happy, everyone's where they need to be. If you need help, certainly reach out to him, or flag us, and we will summon him for you. And lastly, all of you who have experienced the registration system, again, we apologize for any delays in getting it set up, but you see how slick it is once you actually get in there. That is all Kotanu. He is an amazing commerce coordinator and built this system from scratch from us. Wow. Love you, Kotanu. Thank you so much. I don't know what we would do without you.
That was everyone.
And everyone else.
And everybody else will turn. Yay! All right, so with that, I think...
We're good.
Yeah. So, can I get some awesome, revolutionary-themed outro music? Wait for it. I got this on YouTube. Yeah. It's so good. Strokes knows what I'm talking about. It's so good.
Yeah.